Hi guys, welcome to my channel, it's Tracy. Today's video is my favorite video to do of the whole year. I'm going to be showing you the makeup that I'm going to be wearing during the holiday season. Okay, here we go. Natasha Denona's latest Trichrome palette. I really want it, but I can't get every palette that comes out. I know there are a lot of shades in here that I'm not going to be able to pull off, but I really like the top row. So I try to figure out what could I get to cure my green, you know what I mean. So I got online and I ordered one of the Charlotte Tilbury Eye Color Magic Liner Duos. I don't know what's wrong with me. I want a green bag, I want to wear green nail polish, green clothes. Okay, maybe not this one. This is the Charlotte Tilbury Eye Color Magic Liner Duo in the shade Green Lights. I liked it so much that I ordered another one in the shade Copper Charge. One side's matte, one side's metallic, and I like to use the matte side to line the top part of my eyes, and I use the metallic to do the bottom. They're so precise. Well, they're the type of pencil that you have to sharpen. And this one, Copper Charge, it goes so well with the eyeshadow quad, also called Copper Charge. I already did a whole video on this one, so I won't keep telling you how much I love it, but I really, really love it. This one looks pretty dirty already, so I'll try to show you a picture so you can see how pretty it is when it's nice and clean. And here are some swatches. Okay, maybe we should get back to the pencil. So here's the metallic side. I don't want to press too hard. I don't want to break it. And the other side is kind of a purple, red, burgundy, maybe? I don't know. But it's a nice color that goes with so many different looks, especially during the holidays. Oh, after all this, I still wanted the Trichrome palette. I didn't even know that was a word. So I went to MAC and I got two of their Pro palettes, the one on the left, Glitz, and the one on the right, Humid. So this was good. So I thought I'm going to use all these with the Natasha Denona Gold palette. I think this is her best palette. Oh, listen to me, as if I have all her palettes and I've used all of them. No. Should I show you the ones I have? Why not? We're here. I recently got the Biba palette. The Sunrise palette. And the Bronze palette. And I think out of all of the ones I have, the Natasha Denona Gold palette is the best one. Oh, and I don't want to forget the Natasha Denona Mini Nude. I don't want to be sizist. Next is the Charlotte Tilbury Film Star Bronze and Glow Mini. When it came out, I thought it was so cute, but I thought it would be the same size as the Easy Eye palette. It's even smaller than that. Here's the full-sized one on top of the mini one, and you can see the color of the packaging has changed. The older one, it looks more brassy. And I remember when this one came out, so expensive, but at the time, if you were very fair, it was so hard to find a bronzer that didn't make you look orange. So when this was like a really special item. And I remember when I bought it and I thought it was so expensive, but I loved it so much. And years later, I still do. Mine's getting a little old. So when I saw them, you know, I was thinking I'm due to buy a new one, but I really didn't want to. But then I saw the mini come out and I thought, perfect. And it's so cute and so pretty. And if we ever have to travel again, it'll be perfect. Look how pretty, seriously, come on. The Charlotte Tilbury Bejeweled palette. This one's supposed to be limited edition. I don't know why. The formulation and the shine are so gorgeous. Nice pigmentation. It's easy to work with. I've talked about this palette already, and I think I did a video on it, and I think it's probably the best palette for me anyway for the holiday season. Wow, that was rambling. Next, from Chanel, their holiday collection for 2020. I did my last video on these, and if you're wondering, well, why do you have a third one now? It's because before I bought the two pink ones, I had ordered online the gold one because I was only going to get that one in the beginning, and I forgot about it. So I did my video, I posted my video, and then it came in the mail, so you can imagine how happy I was about that. I wasn't very happy. From your left, blush, eyeshadow, eyeshadow. Now I'm trying to use the blush as though it were a highlighter. I keep working with these. I mean, everyone else seems to love them. I don't get it. Okay, let's move on to Dior You know what? They just announced their new Spring Line 2021. It's so new, though, that I can't find pictures on the internet yet. From the Dior Black Knight Holiday Collection, I only got one thing. I got Golden Snow. It's number 549. I'm going to admit it. The packaging really got to me, and the shade on the bottom left, the vintage copper gold with a bit of green. Green. I've used it a few times, and it still looks pretty good. Every time I open this one, it's Christmassy. But these eyeshadows are very, very sheer. They don't have a lot of coverage, and they're going to look even more sheer than this when you put them on your eyes with a brush. So what I do is I start with putting bronzer, or I take out my Wayne Goss palette. I do the base, this shade right here. Are you guys planning to get Wayne Goss's second palette that just came out? I can't wear gray, and I'm so sad about that. Okay, sorry, back to the Dior palette, and then I'll use the Dior shadows on top of that. I have Cashmere on the left, and Nude Dress. Some people on YouTube are saying that the Holiday line is a different formula. This is Cashmere, but I disagree. That I think they're all the same. This is Nude Dress. But Alana Davison on YouTube says that if you get the Backstage palette, there are four different ones, I think, that they're a good buy and they're great quality. I just bought this today, so I can't tell you yet. I just have one more thing I want to talk about. It's the New Face Microcurrent Facial Toning Device. I'm not really going to be able to film anything with the two kind of bulbous mirrors on the top, but I wanted to tell you guys because I know this has been out for a while and I wondered for years, does this do anything? So I finally tried it. I do find it's helping. I find it's giving me a little lift. It's tightening. But don't do what I did and try to be cheap with the priming lotion, because if you don't put enough, you really get zapped. So I ordered two more bottles of the primer, but I didn't really think about when I bought this little machine how expensive the primer was going to be. And when you first get it, you have to use it a lot, but it is helping. It's not plastic surgery or anything, but I do look better. So, you know. And that'll be it for today. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please stay safe. I love you guys, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye for now.